Hey LEGO fans, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with the third version of my minifig scale giraffe, and this is the smallest one yet. I completely redid the thing from scratch because, like I said in my first video, I thought that my first version was too large right from the pretty much from the start, and the second version was as small as I could get it within the constraints of the face that I had created for it. And once I put it into my zoo, it was still looking a little bit big. So I started from scratch, went with a completely, well, not completely, but partially different kind of design strategy for it. Still wanted to get a small face on there, but it's not quite so much horse-like like the original or like the previous one. So here's just a comparison in size between the two. And you can see that I've made it much smaller. So this is, to minifig scale, it's probably not even a full-grown giraffe anymore. Now it's more like a young one. I mean, if you look at that, I don't know. It's something in the range, but I think it still looks a little bit on the juvenile side, which is fine. It's great, though, that I've finally been able to bring in multiple colors. It just was not possible with this version using these tall slope pieces and such, because LEGO just never made those pieces. So I decided to go with the tan on that, but now I'm able to do the more traditional kind of stereotypical yellow based giraffe with some random, you know, I could have done this checkerboard like, but I didn't want to do that. I wanted to make the patterns look a little bit random. That's actually very important in order to have this thing hold itself together for structural stability. I needed some bits that would go through multiple studs. But this one is missing the leg articulation that the first one had, and the second one still had to some degree, but this one adds in the ability to turn the head. So that's really important, because now I can actually make it look a little bit more alive. You can also kind of bend the neck just ever so little to get a little more personality out of it. You know, it's not really legal by LEGO standards to do that, but I think it's okay. Different type of tail here and different type of legs, trying to keep them pretty skinny. I wish that I had four white lightsaber blade lightsaber hilts, but I only have two, so those would have looked better, because giraffes tend to have white coloration towards the bottom of the lower legs. But and I also wish that I had some different colors of these bits for the ears there. But overall, I still think that I came up with something that clearly looks like a giraffe, but now it's much smaller, and I think that this is the best version yet, the most successful version yet. So I'm happier. Do I think that this is done and complete? Did I think that the last one was done and complete? The answer is no. So, you know, as I think up other things, I will continue to try to improve on the design, and if I have to scrap the design completely to do something better, so be it. I will do that. I'm not afraid of getting rid of stuff to do something better. But for now, that's it, and this is what's going to go into the zoo. Well, I said that about the last one, but I'm going to try again, and hopefully this will actually be able to, you know, last for a little while. Either way, hope you enjoyed it, and hope that you will stick around and see more custom stuff that I'm going to be doing very soon. So talk to you again in the next video.